morning students of class 10 welcome back to the classes now let us continue our lesson in english the two stories of flying part 2 the black aeroplane in our previous class we were talking about the writer flew straight into the dark clouds and he could not see anything outside all his instruments were dead He called back to Paris control. The radio was also there. His old aeroplane, Dakota aeroplane, twisted and turned and jumped in the air inside the stormy clouds. And at that time, suddenly he saw a strange black aeroplane flying close to him. There was a sense of relief. Oh, there is somebody else also in the air. I'm not alone. The writer was happy to see the dark aeroplane. The black aeroplane had no lights on, but he could see the pilot's face. He was waving his hand and telling him that follow me. So the writer followed him like an obedient child. So now we'll continue from there. The pilot of the black aeroplane waved his hand and was saying, follow me. He was saying, follow me with his hand. He was showing his hand, waving his hand, showing the gesture, telling him to follow. The writer thought, what did the writer think? He thought, he knows. Oh, the pilot of the black aeroplane knows me that I am in trouble and I am lost. And he was trying to help me. The writer thought that he is trying to help me. He knows that I am lost. So, the pilot of the black aeroplane flew in front of him. The pilot of the black aeroplane put his aeroplane right in front of the writer's plane and he was flying so that it would be easier to follow him. The pilot of the black aeroplane flew his aeroplane right in front of the writer's plane so that the writer could follow him easily. The writer was Point four, the writer was happy. He was very much happy, a sense of relief. There was somebody else to follow him. The writer was very happy to follow that pilot who was flying that black aeroplane. Like an obedient child, as I have told you, he followed him like an obedient child. Number five, it was past half an hour. The aeroplane, the black aeroplane was flying right in front of him. It was past half an hour. For half an hour it was still there. But the strange aeroplane was there in front of him. Still, the black aeroplane was still flying in front of him. It was more than 30 minutes. So, now there was enough fuel for 10 minutes more. The writer knew, he calculated. I have been flying from there to here for this long. Now there must be enough fuel for 10 minutes only. Because he was an experienced pilot, he had flown many times, so he knew how much fuel his aeroplane consumes and how long it takes. Because he was on the last tank, reserve tank, the plane was flying. He knew now there was enough fuel for 10 minutes more. He was starting to feel frightened again. Because he don't know. He was inside the dark clouds, inside the stormy clouds. He don't know in which direction his plane was going or flying. So he was worried. Now there must be fuel for 10 minutes. Then what will happen to me or my aeroplane if the fuel ends or finishes? So he began to feel frightened again. His aeroplane was still flying. The black aeroplane was right in front of him flying. But he was worried. He began to feel frightened again. Suddenly he came out of the clouds. While he was thinking about his fuel and what will happen to him and his aeroplane once the fuel finishes, come to an end. So at that time, suddenly his aeroplane came out of the plane. Now it was very clear again. The moon was shining. Suddenly he came out of the clouds and saw two rows of lights in front of him. He saw two rows of lights. That was an airport. He saw the airport. It was an airport. And he was very happy and relieved. Oh, now the airport has come. Now I can land now. It was a runway. Two rows of light at the side of the runway. There are lights so that it will guide the pilots to land safely. So it was a runway. He was safe. He thought, now I am safe. The writer thought that I am safe. He turned to look for his friend from the cockpit, from the aeroplane. He looked around. Where is my friend who was flying in front of me? He looked for his friend in the black aeroplane. The friend who was flying black aeroplane, who was sitting in the cockpit of that black aeroplane. He was looking for him in the sky, but the black aeroplane was gone. The sky was empty. The sky was empty. He could not see any black aeroplane there. Now, he was only there alone, coming out of the clouds. And he could see the runway, but the black aeroplane was not there. It was gone. What happened to that? We'll continue our lesson in our next class. So that's all for today. You can read this out. Go through the book at home. Don't waste your time and study regularly at home. We'll meet in the next class and discuss about the remaining portion of this lesson. So we'll come to the conclusion at the last. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching the video. That's all for today.